Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I am feeling entirely presentable. Thank you very much. The reason I am feeling entirely presentable is I have decided to do an entire presentation using the free presentation tool in Google Drive. I don't even know what they call it. I've used PowerPoint in the past. I know what that's called. I've used Keynote in the past. I know what that's called. I even remember using a tool called Aldous Persuasion way back in the day. And all of these were great slideshow presentation tools. Well, Google's had a free presentation tool as part of their suite of tools since day one, and I've never given it the time of day. I don't know why. Maybe it's just because I think it's free. How good can it be? Well, shall we figure it out? I think we shall. Over the past few months, I have shown you almost all of the different Google Drive features. I've talked a lot about documents. I've shown you the spreadsheet tool. I've shown you the forms tool, which, as you know, is awesome. But the one tool that I haven't spent much time on or any time on is the presentation tool. I don't know why I haven't. It's almost like I think that that's a tool that you have to spend money on, a presentation tool, because it's, is it more difficult? Probably somewhere in my brain don't believe that a free tool can do as good a job as the paid tools that I use. I'm speaking, of course, of Keynote and of PowerPoint. But I thought we should take a look at it because it is free and it probably does do an awful lot of what we're looking for. So let's dive in and have a look. Now, when you start a presentation using the Google Drive, you then are brought right into immediately a theme picker, very similar to what you would get if you started out with PowerPoint or Keynote. You're going to be given themes to choose from where they've chosen the background and the font and that sort of stuff. Now, they haven't got quite as many themes as you're going to find, nor are they quite as gorgeous as you're going to find in Keynote or in PowerPoint. And some of them are pretty actually darned ugly, but they are free and they do suffice. Now, you start by choosing the format, the slide format that you want, whether you want standard widescreen, the 16:10 newer widescreen format, or the 4:3, the old school format. I'll just leave mine widescreen 16:9 because that's what I like. And then you choose a theme. Now, here's my thought process as I started to use this, because I'm actually using this tool for some presentations that I'm giving this week. I know that when I create presentations in Keynote or in PowerPoint, that I often end up getting lost in the minutiae of building the slideshow, of this transition being absolutely perfect, and that transition working the way I want, and then playing to add some, oh no, I've used two wipes, I'm going to use a fade this time, now I'm going to use a crossfade, I'm going to use a spin-in, and what does that look like? And I lose track of my content, which is so important. So I was thinking, if I'm going to go down this route, I'm going to look for clean and simple as far as creating my presentations. I'm going to concentrate on what's valuable, the content within the presentation, and be a kind of minimalistic about my presentation graphics and that sort of stuff. So I just chose the modern theme for this first little demo that I'm going to be showing you here. Now, I've already pre-baked a few of the slides, so you don't have to wait for me to type them all in. So here's my great presentation. It's Steve's take on everything in this simple format. And I've got a great point that I'm going to make with interesting stuff, and then I'm going to wrap things up with more interesting stuff and perhaps a graphic. Now, what do you do? What do you need when you create a presentation? You need a title slide, and then you need content slides. We have all of those set within this format. If we take a look here, this is the thing about the Google presentation tool, is all of the tools are right here, and there's only a few of them. It doesn't do an awful lot of, as I say, the fancy stuff, but it does the basic stuff. And so the expected things are going to be here. So if you need to choose a layout, for example, you need a title slide or a content slide, this is where you can change the basic format of the slide that you're looking at. It's set right within the layout area. If you want to go into the theme area, you can actually go and you could choose and change the theme that you've chosen from all of the, don't be choosing the color strip or the Western theme, I'm just saying. You know, stick with the simple ones. You could probably design your own look and graphic as well if you choose to do that. But you've got those basic tools, and then we've also got here the transition tool, which allows us to apply transitions to the slides. And you're not going to have the wonderful cube rotations and all that kind of stuff as we see in some of the other packages. These are going to be very basic, simple transitions. So let's actually go to the second slide here, and let's create, I've got a I actually started to create it already. I applied a fade transition to the slide itself, and then if I click on the content area within it, I can add an animation so that my bullets will come in one after the other. And again, nothing fancy. You can choose fade, fly in, fly out, zoom, or spin in. Well, let's just leave fade because that's going to look best. On click or a timed one, so you can time it out, which is good. And then by paragraph means that just every time I put a carriage return in, it's going to add it. And then you can preview it. You can preview how it's going to look. And again, not super fancy, but what you need is a presenter. Your title slide, now your bullet points as you speak when I click the mouse. Pretty much exactly what I'd expect and what I can take advantage of as I create it. Now, the way that they work as far as their actual slide layout goes is when you type in information, it doesn't automatically create bullet points. So you have to add the bullet points yourself. So if I wanted to add bullet points to this, I'll have to click here. And again, remember how I said you can't look, you don't have to look very far for all of the tools? They're just right within here. Go over to the text tools. You don't see the bullets, obviously. Well, just look for something like more. Click on the more, and now we can add numbered bullets as opposed to the bullets, which I had in the first slide. All very simple, very straightforward. The one thing that I haven't talked about is adding graphics. And it's not quite as simple and convenient to add graphics to this. You can't just drag it onto the page, but it is easy to add a graphic just by clicking on the insert graphic, and then you can choose to upload it. And this is very similar to how you would do with any web-based tool. If I wanted to add the Evernote logo that I have for the presentation to this, I would bring in the Evernote logo, and then I can position it wherever I want. I can, again, make it an item that has a transition for when it comes in, so I can bring in graphics at different times, so I can add graphical elements to the slide. Now, if I need to brand all of my slides, say my whole talk was about Evernote and I wanted that Evernote logo in all of the slides, I would just right-click my mouse on that graphic. For some reason, it seems to pop over. There we go. I'll right-click my mouse on the graphic, add it to the theme, and then I can choose which of the slides I want to add that graphic to, and then it's going to be on each and every one of those slides. So if you need your company logo or if you need a graphic like this added to all of the slides, you can do this so you don't have to go through each one and import it. So again, not super fancy, but it's doing the job. It's doing all of the things that I need. If we need to insert some other type of content, you can go in and we can insert things like videos. You can create word art to create fancy titles. You can create different shapes, and you can import animations and other resources that you want to bring to the table. Again, not super fancy, but functional. All of the main things that we need as far as functionality is concerned. Finally, what are the strengths of it? So far I've talked about, you know, the fact it doesn't do anything quite as well, but it does it all well enough. The strengths are when we start thinking about creating collaborative documents. The strengths of Google Drive overall, the fact it's a cloud-based service, and we can create a shared version of our document that we can have multiple people work on and be able to collaborate on, so we can have our whole team, regardless of where they are in the world, editing and managing this document ourselves. Plus, it does a really nice job of incorporating comments from each and every person. We can add comments there or right from here, inserting comments, especially for presentation where people are saying, should we be saying this, or maybe we should be moving this up. Comments are a tremendous tool when you're collaboratively building this sort of a document. Finally, this is all well and good, Steve, except so often you go into a presentation hall to give a presentation and they don't have Wi-Fi and you're not online. What are you going to do then, bright Dotto? Because it's all in the cloud, is it not? Yes, it is. You're absolutely right. It is in the cloud. But if we simply go under the file menu and choose download as, now we have the option to download the entire finished presentation as a PowerPoint slideshow, meaning we can open it in PowerPoint if we want to, and we can even edit it and add to it in PowerPoint, and certainly play it back in PowerPoint, or we can also download it as a PDF, which means that we can then just have any PDF viewer will allow us to play it back. So that's super, especially if we're going to be presenting from a tablet or something like that. So we've got lots of different options as far as using this finally using this presentation. As I said, I'm going to be trying it out this week. I've got an online presentation that I'm giving and a physical presentation that I'm giving in person. And I'm going to be using this tool instead of PowerPoint or, in this case, Keynote for all of those talks. So we'll see how it goes. But I've got tremendous confidence that it's going to work. You know what? If I didn't have confidence that was going to work, I wouldn't use it because I wouldn't take a chance. But this is allowing me to concentrate on what's important, the content in the slides, and spend a little bit less time worrying about all of the foo-foo-rah around the slides. That's it for today. There are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here in Dotto Tech. Please consider subscribing to our channel. That way you get information about every video as soon as we release it. Also, sign up for our newsletter. We send out a weekly digest of all of our videos. As well, we let you know about our webinars that we have coming up, which we do a fair number of, and my gosh, they are usually full of good content. And finally, Dotto Tech is a crowd-funded channel. In other words, we rely on you, the people who view our videos, to help carry the freight and pay for the channel instead of me going out and getting corporate sponsorship. This allows me to spend more time concentrating on creating videos like the one you've just seen. We do it through the crowdfunding site Patreon. Have a click there, take a look at what we have to say. There's some perks attached if you decide to become one of our patrons to you, as well as obviously to us. And for as little as a dollar a month, you can ensure that Dotto Tech continues producing great content and know that you are part of our community, and I appreciate it so much. With that, I am done for the day. I've got to get working on my presentation. You get working on yours. Have fun storming a castle.